Welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Neeru Tandon from Department of English, BSSG College, Kanpur. In this paper of English language teaching, this module is based on research methods, methodology, and particularly formatting the research paper. We have already discussed in two modules that how to go for research. But when it comes to the format of the research paper, how to write, how to quote, how to write the bibliography, all these problems are immense for the researcher. So let us discuss all these things in this particular module. To revise that, what is research? Research should be taken as a studious inquiry or examination for the purpose of gaining new knowledge. It answers what, who, when, where, why, how questions and gives answers. Now, it is important to remember that the process of writing and research is recursive. You may write a section, move on to another section, not even completing that, and then go back and revise and add something or delete something. Because when you gain some knowledge, then the previous knowledge that you had, you will like to modify it. In that sense, writing a research paper is not always the straightforward process that you have written something and that's it. The standard form of the research paper can be used as a checklist at the early stage of your research project and again later as a writing model at the final phase of your research. Often we hear that your paper should be according to the APA style. What is this APA style paper writing? It needs title page, abstract, introduction, methods, results, discussion, references, appendix, tables, figure captions, and figures. When you use all these things in your research paper, then according to the APA style, you have got a different setting to use them. There are 11 steps for any research paper that way. First, select the topic. Then narrow that topic. Like suppose you have used feminism, then you will have to narrow the topic that you want to use, the feminist drama or the novel or whatever dramatist or novelist you want to take up. That kind of narrowing down and coming to a problem is required. Then search for sources from where you can get the material and the interviews and the primary and the secondary sources for this particular topic. Read and take notes. Once you get hold of the data or the sources and the books, read them extensively. Now, how to read for your research paper is again very important thing. First reading should be a cursory reading. Then reread them, and at that point, while reading, just mention in a copy or in that particular book that this particular information is being dealt in which part of your thesis, because by that time you must have given the chapter division. So in what chapter, under what subtitle, this particular reading will help you. So note down at that particular time, like chapter 3, section 4. So whenever you are supposed to sit and write down about section 4 or particular this particular section, then you will just open that point and start reading and writing that. So you will not again go through the whole thing. Then create an outline, give headings or subheadings for that. Then write your rough draft. Don't just jump to write the final draft. Then in-text citations should be well covered. Just check whether whatever you have cited, the resources, the references are proper or not. Then come to reference page. There are many ways of writing references. You may take it as the end note. You may take it as different ways are there, so as per your subject you can choose, but it should be consistent from beginning till end. Then revise and rewrite, taking care of each and every word that you are writing. If you find the synonym better, replace it. And then write and proof the final draft. After writing, the researcher feels so tired, sometimes boring, that he is not in the position to do the proofreading. But proofreading is must. Because at the time of proofreading, most of the time it happens that you feel to change or modify your presentation of research. You can take help from others also, your peer group, for proofreading, because most of the time it also happens that some mistakes committed by you cannot be noticed by you so easily, and others can notice it. And finally, rewrite your thesis. Now, in this particular figure, you can see that research philosophy, research approaches, research strategies, and then time horizon, and finally the data collection methods are discussed. Now, let us take the format of the research one by one. The very first attempt is there to make the title. The title of the thesis is very, very important. The title of that particular research paper creates the first impression about the paper. People may decide to read or not to read that paper simply by its title. Whenever we search for papers, search for books, most of the time we search by the title. If you send your manuscripts to a journal, your title may determine to whom the journal editor assigns it for review. The APA publication manual recommends titles to be 10 to 12 words long, not more than that, and not even less than that. A major consideration is that the title will be cataloged in various databases. So if it is two or three sentences long, then it will be difficult to consider it. One approach is to enclose of the working title to hold your preliminary thoughts. I repeat. What happens that when you give title and later on you feel that your research work is going on in some other direction, then you want to modify your title. In that process, you can just do that, give a workable title to your thesis and finally choose it after finishing your research work. Title case refers to a system in which the first letters of main words in a title are capitalized, but all other letters are in lowercase. So an example of the title case is, you can say, feminine psyche and theater. You will notice that the word and is not capitalized. F of feminine, P for psyche, and T for theater are in the capital letters. So whenever you are just putting your title, try to take care of this particular sample. A title contains keywords to describe your topic that can be used by others to explore the same. Suppose I have written feminine psyche. So whosoever is interested in feminism or the feminine psyche will take care of this research work. Or if anybody wants to know how feminine psyche is being expressed in theater, he or she will go for this particular topic. So the right and the wrong, suppose another example, like if you write a paper on LSRW, writing skills, and you want others interested in LSRW to be able to explore your paper. If you have titled your paper as the right and the wrong, readers may not identify what your topic is. The language interested readers will not go for this topic, the right and the wrong. It is ambiguous. What is right? What is wrong? It is about what? The title then could be changed to Basics of LSRW, the Right and the Wrong. The things will be absolutely clear and people will go and consult your paper. After discussing and understanding how to title your paper, let us come to the hypothesis. The research hypothesis also needs to be clearly stated and presented as part of a theoretical framework in the research report. Most of the time, part of the hypothesis is there in the title itself. It is important to note that not all quantitatively oriented papers specify hypothesis or predictions. Somewhere only the title guides you towards your hypothesis, and towards the end you prove the research question. So either it may be in the form of the hypothesis or in the form of the research question. According to APA model, the abstract of your research paper should precede. An abstract must include a lot of information in a short space and are typically limited to a specified number of words. They are submitted as part of paper manuscripts to journals. They are sent as part of the application package for conference presentations, and they function as a summary that readers use to decide if they want to read the whole paper or not. Then comes the part of starting your research paper in actual. We just start the introduction of the research paper without using the word introduction, because for academic or the research papers, they don't have any specified size, but it must convey the sense. A complete introduction to a research paper includes 5 parts: a general topic indicator, a statement of the specific aspect of the topic or a statement or a brief history of the problem, then an operational definition of the terms, various terms being used in the research, a literature review, the purpose of the paper, and one or more research questions. There comes data gathering. It is clear that the means for gathering data was appropriate for the research questions. It should be sufficient and detailed information provided about how, when, where the data were gathered. Now, what is the major problem that researchers come across? We have 3 tenses: present, past, and future. And which tense should be used for presenting the data as a research paper? Generally, using the past tense in all sections is common because the research had already been accomplished. It makes sense. However, Swales and Feek have surveyed research paper using the IMRD, that is Introduction, Method, Result, and Discussion model, and conclude that the present tense is more common in the introduction and discussion, and later on researchers, they move to the past tense. Past tense, which is more common in the methods and result section. The literature review explains the context for the research together with details about the findings, strength and weaknesses of the previous studies in the area. They want to prove that whatever topic they have selected and from whatever angle they are researching is unique and nobody else has done that till date. A literature review is a collection and evaluation of the written material available on the topic, but it must be pertinent to the topic of the researcher. It may be helpful to look at your research question, RQ, basically termed as. The RQs guide the composition of the literature review. If material doesn't justify your research question, then it is not significant to your literature review. So let us check, are all the relevant studies surveyed? Does the review provide an accurate and objective summary of the current state of the art and the theoretical framework of the study? Then only you can just decide about your literature review, because the purposes of the literature review are manifold. It motivates the study and provides background. It informs readers about the relevance of the topic. A literature review identifies the academic records by expressing whatever knowledge one has gained and from whatever source. The literature review stipulates a paper track indicating where to find the articles, books, and other resources used. In that sense, it is a source file for others to access. It provides researcher and readers alike ideas for further research. Literature read for the literature review may give a researcher idea as well as possible research designs to draw from, replicate, or modify. For example, in doing a literature review, you may come across problems which can be addressed or may become research questions. Then choose the methodology appropriate for your topic. Where to start, what to do, applied research or action research, classroom-based research or teacher research, or it should be experimental research, and why, there is no consensus. It depends upon the researcher. The hot debates carried on in the past over the superiority and application of two research traditions, quantitative and qualitative, have resulted in the increasing interest in the third type of orientation, that is the mixed methods. And most probably and commonly, mixed method is being used. Now let us talk about results and discussions. We have done our research, we have already gathered the data. Now the research is completed. It's time of the result and discussing those results. Objective is to present the results obtained after doing research, and this can usually be best achieved by presenting the data mainly in tables and figures with necessary verbal explanation, that is the proof. State each result and discuss it immediately. Technicalities can be included. Interpretation and magnitude of each outcome in a qualitative way will be the part of the result. In addition, the possible theoretical or practical significance of results should be discussed. Possible areas for future research must be mentioned, because whatever topic you may have taken, that may not complete the research, and there are certain more associated research questions that have not been included in that. So avoid repetition in the discussion. Interpret findings and author's opinions should be included towards the conclusion. Necessarily, there is a research cycle. It starts with a problem, deals with objective, then the research strategy, design, literature review, side by side gathering of the data, then interpretation of the data and interpretation of the findings, and then they should be related with the research problem well. So all of them are interrelated in the cyclic motion. After your research work, the question and the real problem comes in the form of references. How to cite references? Most style guides require researchers to ensure that all citations in report of research, whether books, articles or chapters, and only those citations are included in the correct format in the reference list. Most of the research papers may be good research papers, they get refusal from the publication side if the references are not well cited. All citations in the research report should be consistent with the same style guide. It is important to consider carefully how secondary sources will be cited, when to include the complete and original references in case when you cite someone who cited someone. Now, software programs, if you are taking help from that, even that are supposed to be used in the reference section, such as EndNote. They have been designed to automate this task. In terms of the content, it is also obviously the responsibility of the author to ensure that the references are appropriate for the study described. Citation may look different depending on what is going to be cited and which style was used to create them. So, researcher should choose an appropriate style guide according to the subject chosen for the study. Citation should consist of author's name, then the title of the book or article or journal as the case may be, then the date of the publication, then the page numbers, and after that volume or the issue numbers of article, or if it has been taken from the journal. Here is the example of an article citation using four different citation styles. MLA style, which is commonly used for literature reviews and literature papers, it states like that: Tandon, comma, Nehru, then put a full stop. Just don't forget to put this full stop. Then single inverted comma and the title: Feminism, a Paradigm Shift. And quote, close this, and then full stop. Then the place of New Delhi, again colon, name of the publication, that is Atlantic Publishers and Distributors, again full stop, year of the publication, again full stop, and then particular page number, so and so. This is one accepted and the common language style. All references cited should be presented in the alphabetical order of the first author. Like if there is Tandon Nehru, so T will be considered as the letter. If there is some anise, so that A will be considered. After that T will come, or so it should be there in the alphabetical order, and wherever necessary by the second and subsequent authors. So this is just an example of the bibliography. You can see this, and then I will just explain how you should go ahead. All references should be properly numbered. If not numbered as 1, 2, 3, then you can use in the Roman numerals also. Reference should provide, I told you, name of the authors, title, name of the book, year, month, or volume number and page number. Now, bibliography. It is different from the references. In both the places, you give citation, but the method of putting it is different. Bibliography is a list of the sources you use to get information for your report. It is included at the end of your report, not at the end of your chapters. You will find it easier to prepare your final bibliography if you keep track of each book, encyclopedia, article you use as you are reading and taking notes. I told you, when at the time of the first reading, you are supposed to make the note then and there only. In the same way, when you start writing, so whenever you have just wrote that particular point in your answer sheet, there only within bracket, write the source from where you have taken. Start a preliminary or draft bibliography by listing on a separate sheet of paper all your sources. Note down the full title, author, place of publication, publisher, and date of publication for each source. Suppose you have written only the name of the author, then later on you may forget that which book you were consulting. Or if you have written only the book and the author, then which edition you were consulting, you may not be able to remember, because there are various editions of one book and you must write down which edition you have consulted while quoting. Also, every time a fact gets recorded on a note card, its source should be noted in the top right corner. When you are finished writing your paper, you can use this information on your note cards to double check your bibliography. When assembling a final bibliography, list your sources. You should be very clear that whether whatever you are quoting written by one author or more than one author, because in that case, the way of quoting will be different. Whether it is a book, it is a journal, it is a newspaper, it is electronic source, all will be different in the style of quoting. When you write a bibliography by hand, use underlining as shown in the guide below. If you use a computer to write your bibliography, all the publication names, all the names of the books which are published separately should be in italics. For an encyclopedia, you should write first the encyclopedia title, then the edition date, then the volume number, article title within inverted commas, then page numbers. For example, you can say the Encyclopedia Britannica, 1997, full stop, volume 7, this is the name of the particular title and followed by page number. There no use of the name of the writer, because encyclopedia is encyclopedia, the writer is not important over there. For a magazine, author's last name first, then article title, then name of the magazine, volume number, date and page number. In the same manner, like Jordan, Jennifer. For a newspaper, again it will be different. Authors, if available, last name first, like who wrote that article in which newspaper. So article title, then name of the newspaper. Not only name of the newspaper, like you written Times of India, but of Times of India have various cities publication. So you will have to write Times of India Delhi edition. State of publication, date, edition if available, section, then page numbers. For a person, then you will have to write full name, occupation, date of interview. If you are taking interview of some author or some person, then you will have to quote this. If your source is a film, then title of the film first, then director, then distributor, and the year. The same goes with the CD, whatever you have just consulted. So which file it was? It was in the Microsoft Word file, or what kind of file, JPEG file, whatever type of file it was, you must mention that too. Then online resources, mostly you take data from internet, and how will you can say bibliography instead of bibliography. The recent word being used is webliography. So there you can write author of message, date, subject of message, electronic conference or bulletin board, available email and email address. Then magazine article and newspaper article, they will also be just expressed in this particular manner on your screen. Now World Wide Web, www, that we already know, section of website, so that must be there and mentioned properly. And digital files, cite a digital file by its source type. At the end of the entry, include the name of the digital format. Footnotes, endnotes, figures and tables, how to include that in your research paper. Like the reference list, footnotes, endnotes, figures and tables must adhere to a standardized presentation that is consistent with a single style guide. Now, what is the difference between footnotes and endnotes? Footnote means that at that very page, you just write the references. And endnote means after the completion of the research paper you write, or the chapter you write at the end. Because many style guides suggest citing authors parenthetically within the text itself, footnotes and endnotes are generally not being used for citing sources. Rather, they are used to include information that, although relevant, does not fit into the flow of the text. They may include supplemental content, additional sources for further reading on the topic, or copyright information. If they are longer, authors should consider incorporating the information into the body of the paper or including it as an appendix. Both footnotes and endnotes are usually indicated and referenced with superscript Arabic numerals consecutively numbered. Endnote is a software program that is known as www.endnote.com, which arranges things accordingly. Figures are used to display information discussed in the text in a concise format that is easy to comprehend. They generally consist of graphs, diagrams, charts, illustrations, or photographs. Each figure must be identified by a number ordered consecutively and given a brief and descriptive caption. In most of the theses or dissertations, figures appear in the text itself and are also listed in a separate table. After that, author's note in the form of acknowledgement should be part of the research paper. Many reports of research include a section in which people who have helped with the research are thanked. It may be in the beginning itself, before starting the research paper, or towards the end as well. In journal articles and book chapters, an author's note of thanks may appear either as a footnote or as the end note, whereas in a book, it may be part of the preface or even the dedication. Researchers, they often wish to thank their participants, colleagues, or assistants. They also thank the libraries from where they gathered the material. Any consultant who may have helped with statistics or ideas are also thanked. Grant support is also often acknowledged in the author's note. Suppose somebody has taken grant from UGC, then also it is included. There are some research ethics and it should be followed. The first and the foremost important is plagiarism, borrowing the material from others without acknowledging them. The best way to avoid plagiarism is to cite your sources both within the body of your paper and in the bibliography of sources. A style of research should be different from an essay, prose, biography or autobiography. Colloquial words and expressions should be avoided. Thesis writing, researchers need to evaluate the quality of any work before citing it. In summarizing, paraphrasing or quoting, keep an accurate record of the original source. Try to be both thorough and concise. Above all, strive for accuracy and originality. Do not expect your first draft to be the last draft. Review and rewriting are always necessary. Citing sources are important, and one must note in the preface itself which style they are following, APA, MLA, whichever format they are following, they must quote it so that the evaluators may just judge accordingly. Line citation into the text of the paper is also important to understand. Typically, the inline citation would consist of the author's last name followed by the page number with the entire citations in bracket. For example, Winthrop 24. The sentence period comes after the citation. More is to follow on proper inline citation format. Paraphrase. It is an important part of writing a paper. Simply put the paraphrase when you read another author's work and put it into your own words. It is not your creative piece of writing. You are just paraphrasing. So you must cite that according to so and so. So that way you have given the source also, but no need to give the complete details in this course. Do not use quotation marks when paraphrasing. Direct quote. Most things should be paraphrased, but when you use the writer's own words, then they should be there in the quotation marks. Works cited page, the last page of your paper where you list using the format shown. Justify the left-hand margin. Remember to check that all citations in the paper are listed in your references and all citations in the reference section are in the paper. Final touches and formatting. I told you proofreading is very, very important. Go for proofreading. Then just check the language also. Check the use of words also. And formatting, that where, how much margin is supposed, that you are supposed to leave. And what should be the size of the letters. And everything else should be just discussed. General guidelines. Type your paper on a computer and print on standard white 8.5 into 11 inch paper. Double space the text of your paper and use a legible font that is usually Times New Roman, either 12 or 13. Whatever font you choose, MLA recommends that the regular and italics type styles contrast enough that they are recognizable one from another. The standard font size should be 12. Leave only one space after periods or other punctuation marks. Set the margins of your document to 1 inch on all sides. Indent the first line of paragraphs 1/2 inch from the left margin. And MLA recommends that you use the tab key as opposed to pushing the space bar 5 times. Create a header that numbers all pages consecutively in the upper right hand corner, 1/2 inch from the top and flush with the right margin. Your italics throughout your essay for the titles of longer words should be there. If you have any endnote, include them on a separate page before your work cited. The same page should not be continued. So I hope you have gathered all information and ready for writing the research paper. Continue researching and sharing it with your peers. Thank you for visiting EPG Pathshala.